Boo! It's Battleship Cobra, aka Mike Taylor, or Mike Taylor, aka Battleship Cobra. Hey guys, I'm back. I wanted to make more content. I was just making excuses, and I want to not be focused so much on being perfect and just produce content and make some useful stuff for you guys. If you want to support me, go to BattleshipCobra.com and check out all my stuff. Most notably, the Crystal Reports course that I have for SAP Business One and SQL for SAP Business One. I also have a working from home course, which I made a while ago. It's really applicable now. You might want to check it out. It's just 30 minutes on my tips from working from home. I worked from home for a long time. So check those out, BattleshipCobra.com. Today, what are we gonna do? Have you ever been working through your Crystal Reports designs for layouts in particular, and you needed the document entry, the doc entry, not the doc number? Because if you're using the doc number, the SAP layouts actually need the doc entry. So I'll give you an example, and I'll show you a quick trick that a colleague of mine, Matt, showed me, and it'll save you a lot of time. I use it almost every day now. It's a little quick tip. So let's jump onto the demo system. So what you want is, you can see this doc number is not always going to be the same as your doc entry, which you need to do a Crystal Reports layout. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out my Crystal Reports course, crystal.battleshipcobra.com, or go to battleshipcobra.com and you'll figure this out. So this is what a Crystal Reports layout looks like if you're familiar with it in SAP. I'm going to push F5 to preview, but what is it asking me for? The doc key, not the document number, but the doc entry. And also the object ID, I'm not gonna deal with that as much today. So how do you find the doc key? Well, one thing, you can go tools, queries, and just write your own query every time. So you can go QUT. I already know that that's the header table. How do I know that? Well, if you took my course on SQL, you'd know that, or Crystal Reports. But if you click view system information, hold your mouse over here, one of these fields, you'll see in the bottom left, I don't know where my head's gonna be floating, but bottom left somewhere. If you look in that, I'll try, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Just look in the bottom left of the screen. OQUT, so we know that's the header record. So these are the header area here, and these are the rows. So we just want the header because we want to find the data for the document entry. So you can see here that tricky, tricky SAP, they didn't even put the doc entry anymore. So even on top of that, you need to type out your doc entry, and then you need to say where. Well, I can click this one here. Doc num equals 20020. And here, I'll put this in here just to show you. So the way that the system sees it, the doc entry is a unique number in the database that relates to the document number. The document number is not unique enough. The doc entry is sequential, okay? So anybody that knows that already knows it's kind of a pain. I have a couple other ways to do that. What you can do is you can go, and I made a query. Here's my query, and I'll throw this query in the link, the description below. You can run this query. I already saved it as a special doc entry and object ID finder, but you can also save it in your regular query manager. But you click doc entry and object ID finder. I'm using B1UP a lot in this, so I used B1UP to make a menu item there. Just keep that in mind. So I type my doc number that I want to know. Comes up with 20020, doc entry 11, and object type 23. So now what can I do? I can go 11. And object entry 23, or object ID 23. I'm gonna have to enter my password. And boom, you get the exact document that we were looking at. Okay, so the reason that's so important is you might wanna test a whole bunch of invoices, and you would have to look up that information every time, and it just starts to get annoying. So I have another little trick that you can use that I made with B1UP. I made a little thing here with a B1 validation and a macro where you can just double click on the document number, and it'll pop up the doc entry and the object ID. So I'll throw that in the link below. I'll just put a package together for this video. But the trick I wanted to show you today is even simpler. If you already know the object ID, and I'll throw a list of object IDs in the description as well. If you already know your object ID and you just want the doc entry, here's a super simple trick. And this is the real only takeaway from this video. That's why I wanted to do it so quickly. Just go to the document you want, click Tools, Change Log, and the freaking object ID is right here. See 11? This has saved me minutes every day. It's just so quick, right? So whatever you want to go, you go back one, Tools, Change Log, number 10, and all you can do then is just type that into your crystal reports, obviously if they're sequential, it's easy. But if you're looking for a specific layout and you know you've done it, trying to find that doc key is very, very annoying. So a lot of these are the same, but say I wanted to do, let's see, number one. Let's keep going here. So all you have to do, Tools, Change Log, grab your doc entry from there, throw it in your crystal report, and boom, that's it. That's it for me for today. This is just a short one. I want to do videos every week. Mondays at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I'm gonna try to do one per week, guys. I have a whole bunch of ideas. I really appreciate your support. I've had so many messages. Get in touch with me at linkedin.battleshipcobra.com. Just connect with me on LinkedIn, send me a message, say hi. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, guys. I'll see you next time.